You're finished!
Finally.
Sid, are you hurt?
I'm fine, I think.
No.
What is it?
A diary. I gave it to Chadwick before we went our separate ways. He was here. Do you think that creature?
I'm sure he fought bravely to the last. The girl is safe thanks to him.
Chadwick, you fool.
Come on. We have to get her back to the hideaway. We don't want his sacrifice to have been in vain.
No, of course not. I'll see that she's looked after from now on. It's the least I can do.
From what I hear, you've barely left the girl's side in days. I hope she's recovering from her ordeal.
She is. Slowly, but surely. She's far tougher than she looks. I thank the flames we found her. If we hadn't...
I know. But we did. I'm sorry we weren't able to save Chadwick.
There's no need to apologize. Without your help, I would never have found out what happened to him. How he fought to the bitter end to save her. To save Haida Marie. That's the man I remember. The man I thought of as a brother.
I wish I could have met him. I'd like to hear more about your past. If you don't mind, that is.
Of course. You already met my former master. She trained Chadwick and I to do two things. Kill and obey. We were supposed to be sold to the highest bidder when the time came. But no bid was ever high enough to convince her to part with us. For years, we were her daggers in the shadows. But we could never quite shake our doubts about the things she made us do. And then, one day, we just couldn't do them anymore. So we escaped. But staying together was out of the question. They would have found us too easily. After so many years of training, the pull to serve was always strong. It scared me to think he might have taken another master, become a dagger in someone else's hand.
But even in captivity, the battles he fought were his own. And he died not as someone's tool, but as a hero.
Haida Marie is proof of that. Bearers can cast off their shackles. And the Cursebreakers will show them how. I'll fight until my dying breath to see it done. For Chadwick, and for all of us.
Thank you, Doris. We'll be counting on you.
Food in the hideaway. Sometimes, in my cell, my tummy rumbled so loud that Chadwick would sneak me some gruel from his bowl. I miss him. He would have liked this place.
An empty shelf.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot. All yours. Come again. I may have more for you.
Haida Marie has taken a liking to her new home. How her spirit survived Balmung Dark unbroken, I'll never know.
Still alive, are you? You're rubbing me blind, you know.
Finished, are you?
Knowledge hoarded is knowledge lost. Compiled some new entries, if you would like to see them. What subject shall we consider today? The door to the shelves.
Ready, girl? Yeah!
Much for you, eh, Torgal? Let's go.
Faster!
Village looks abandoned. Now, which house would a bookworm live in? His interests were certainly varied. This is it. But if what it says is true, I need to get this back to the hideaway.
Leaving so soon, stranger. We've been watching you from a distance, so to speak.
Subtle. I know who you are.
Then we need not waste time on introductions. Hand me the book. Leave it in our care and return to your life.
Your care? Do you mean to burn it or bury it?
That is not my decision to make, but by one means or another, its contents shall be removed from the common record.
Then I'll have to politely refuse. I won't let you erase our history.
Then we find ourselves at an impasse. Very well. The book can just as easily be pried from your dead hand.
Let's see, shall we?
Impressive. But we have other means. We shall claim the book yet.
Why do you want it so badly anyway?
It lays out in no uncertain terms the vanity and avarice of mankind. It tells the shameful history of the persecution and oppression of a gifted few by a giftless many. Would you say that this interpretation was correct?
I don't know.
You don't know. Your sword may be sharp, but your wits are dull. So let me answer for you. There is no correct interpretation of history. That a series of events took place may be proved beyond a doubt. But there can be no single, immutable explanation as to why they came to pass. It is a question of numbers and of belief. If enough people believe that a set of events occurred for a reason, that belief becomes the truth.
So you're trying to control the truth?
We are trying to protect people from themselves, from knowledge that would bring them naught but pain. That is all. You may keep the book, for now. The world is small. We shall meet again. Until then.
Wait! Damn it.
Let's get this back to Vivian. Perhaps she can explain what that was all about.
Ready, girl? Hopefully the registry is still here. Disposed of. Conditioning. This is nothing short of torture. Herman wasn't exaggerating. It's a wonder he survived this place. I need to find that registry. This reads like a suicide note. Did the director go through with his plan? There's only one way to find out. forked white tree. This must be the place. Could he really be buried here? There's something hidden among the roots. Let's see. This must be the registry. So many names. This place was a slaughterhouse. But where is the architect of all this misery? It was only a matter of time, I suppose. This place is cursed. I'm done here. Let's get the registry back to Herman. Vivian. I found it. The book you lost.
You found it. Thank you, Clive. Even though I asked this of you, I was not entirely sure it would be possible. I feared the executors had seized every copy.
I met with one of these executors, and I convinced him to let me keep it. He told me something. That the truth is just a matter of collective belief. And that if enough people believe a lie, that lie becomes the truth.
It does. But it also means that the truth is not immutable. That it can be changed. Provided that those who wish to change it can convince enough people that their perspective is the correct one. As the sad history of the bearers proves.
You said that the book inspired you to become a scholar.
It did. Or its author, rather. She was a heretic, you see. A firebrand and a dissenter. A gallows stood ready for her in every corner of the realm. And by shunning society, or perhaps being shunned by it, she stumbled upon a truth so potent that an entire realm trembled at the prospect of its utterance. I, too, have always felt somehow set apart from the world of men. A stranger to my own species. She taught me that my solitude was not a curse, but a gift. And that, though my journey to the truth might be a lonely one, what I found at my destination would be more than worth the cost.
Do you still feel that way? That you're not one of us?
Honestly, I'm not entirely sure anymore. Since coming to the Hideaway, I find my thinking somewhat clouded. Perhaps the result of studying mankind from a rather closer perspective than I had intended. But the more I study, the more I find value in this perspective. In looking not from the outside, but from within. So if you'll permit me, I'd like to continue my work here. Remember, Clive, when enough people believe, belief begets truth. Give the men and women of this benighted world the gift of truth. Make them believe in you, as I do.
I'll try, Vivian. I'll try.
Clive. Truth is but a matter of belief. Alas. I do so enjoy our little chats.
I hear that you traveled to Ash, Cid. Did you by any chance recover the names of my fallen friends?
I did. Yes.
If I may, the bearer registry. The director was a brutal man. He got no worse than he deserved.
The registry was all I found beneath the tree. There was no sign of a body. Nor any record of what happened to the children after the orphanage closed.
I pray that at least some of them survived. All their names are here. The ones we lost. My friends. My light in those dark times. I can still remember their faces. Like it was yesterday. Children who were taken from their bunks in the morning, never to return. No explanation ever offered.
They'd be happy to know that you survived, Herman.
But why did I make it out alive when so many others died in that awful place?
It's not your fault. And blaming yourself won't bring them back. Honor their memory. See that their names live on. That way, at least. They're never truly gone.
Thank you. Sid, I'm going to write a book. An account of the horrors of Badbach, and the spirit of those its custodians sought to crush. All of Valisthea will know of our suffering. And in the name of those I lost, I will not let it happen again.
Neither will I.
These records would have been buried for all eternity, were it not for you. Thank you. The realm will hear of Badbach. And I pray that the tale of my fallen friends will spare future generations the horror we endured. Thank you for helping keep their memory alive.